I've forgotten. Well, I guess we can talk about like the nerfs and whatnot that we that have come into play here. Tidehunter,
prepare
damage on Ravage has been lowered just a bit, and his move speed, I believe, was slowed by 5, if I'm not mistaken. Oh, I remember what I want to say. Rubick, since we were just talking about him, he has some amazing abilities to steal, and they're not really that difficult to take. I mean, even just Blade Fury, which you'll get pretty much every time, if not an on. And basically, anytime you spell steal from Kuroki, it's going to be a good spell, basically, even if it's a healing ward.
Nice hit,
against the Ravage, Doom, even the Storm. Storm ulti is super good in the right situation.
Nice hat, Kuro.
I guess.
What? Kuro?
Yeah.
Oh, of course.
He got the hat right.
Yeah, that's right. Is that, that's not our blade. That means none of his abilities are changed.
He only has the hat on.
Questionable decision here from Kuroki.
Yeah. Questionable decision making from all of Team Secret, letting Kuro play this hero without wearing the full set.
Yeah, unbelievable. So Misery's going to be playing the Doom, S4 on his Storm Spirit. We've seen that once or twice. Kuroki, of course, as we talked about on the Jug. No-Tail Tidehunter and Puppy Kotol. Oh, this might be a... it's not the greatest gank.
Interesting laning setup this might be for Na'Vi, with Funic PA bottom, possibly together with Goblax Dazzle. Solo mid LC from Solo. And then FE Rubick together with Vos, Lycan, and
Funic is going to be forced to get Blink Strike right away. And Secret takes the Bounty Rune, but the top one is taken for Chavos on the Lycan.
They cannot possibly lane it like this. This is going to be awful. They're going to need to help their bot lane even more than this. PA without farm is a garbage hero, let's be honest.
Garbage tier?
She's one of the worst heroes in the game without farm. Because
are you surprised with the setup?
Yeah, that's what I mean. I understand that they want to prioritize farm and get Lycan a good start, that makes perfect sense, but they're really sacking their PA, and if they wanted to do this, they could probably... They could solo PA bottom and start mid with Dazzle to get LC a really good start against Storm, or they could just have Dazzle pulling top while Rubick tries to hold away Misery, which seems to be a pretty difficult task for FNG right now. Really fighting him.
He wants it, he wants the right click. Man, that is a lot of damage.
Yeah, Misery's playing without stealth though, so zero armor, he basically takes full damage from all attacks. Overall, a decent trade here for FNG in this situation.
Even S4 getting ridiculously low against the solo of Solo on Legion Commander, solo mid. Get it? Good. Misery continues
to first blood top. Misery just went into farm.
Top.
Never mind, solo, first blood mid.
Yes, thank you, Cinderin.
I was gonna say Misery's gonna die here, he's one attack away. Chvost, if he could have got one swing there, that was a kill, but... I was very surprised Misery went in further there. He was low, doesn't have any armor or anything, and let Rubick telekinesis him back, but... Yeah, first blow was mid, sorry if you missed it. I was sure it was gonna be a kill there on top.
That one actually, for once, wasn't your fault. It was both of our faults together, Cinderin.
Okay,
it's actually never your fault, but I like to blame you anyway.
Fault.
I know. S4, 8-3 versus the Legion Commander, who is 2-2, actually, so... He's winning this lane very heavily, especially after that first blood. Juggernaut about to hit level 3. Do they have any real kill potential in this bottom lane with the Jug? Because of the, not only the Blink Strike, but the Grave as well, which I'm assuming is leveled. It is not. So right now, I guess they do. But perhaps at level 2 will be much more difficult. But again, it's going to be tough to kill Kuroki in his own right, so I think the supports could roam a bit if they want. In fact, No-Tail went Gush. We don't really see Tidehunter in this role very often anymore, so that's actually cool to see.
It's extremely rare that he's not solo offlane.
Yeah.
Or solo safe lane in some compositions when you want to run an aggressive try, but he can still work as a support, does very well with levels, doesn't really need much farm. I mean, it's great luxury when you get Blink Refresher, of course, but just getting a level 6. The reason Tide never gets played as a support pretty much is that in comparison to other heroes in support role, it just doesn't offer that much until level 6, and that's what you generally want your supports to really secure, is that early game. But in Captain's Draft, the rules change, and you can get away with something like this.
Yes, try this in pubs all you want. Might actually work. Probably not. No-Tail has the Gush available to him for a last-ditch effort. Blink Strike is there as well, but here comes the Blade. He actually doesn't even need it. Blink Strike is already used. 8-second cooldown. Okay, he's going to use it just in case. Is he actually going to live here? Blink Strike is up in 3 seconds. And
oh, they missed
Wand
it
at the last second. No-Tail has Gush. He has Gush. There it is. 2-0 advantage for Secret. That took a lot longer
really
than I
close.
Thought. But...
Yeah, me too. I was sure Funic was going to die in that.
That was well played by
two wrong calls for me so far. I'm on a streak.
I don't even know what my streak is. I've lost count at this point.
Oh, but they're trying a bit of pressure on No-Tail, but Anchor Smash, even on level 1, even like after the nerf to the damage reduction, so it scales instead of being 60 on all levels, it's still 45% on level 1. You're playing a PA into that.
Yeah.
So much of your damage just gone. S4. Maybe thinking about this.
Well, somebody's gonna
probably shouldn't be thinking about this.
S4 getting pretty low. Solo has no mana to work with, though, and Misery. All he can do is right click, but this might be enough to take out the Rubick. We're gonna watch this fight at the top rune as well. Doesn't look like he's gonna be killed anytime soon. Misery. He's gonna finish off the Rubick with relative ease, and S4
nice
lives to
see
another day.
Pickup.
On Doom? Oh, yeah, you're right.
Probably the reason he got that kill. And surprising to see him get it when he's playing that offlane, but realizes that he might get a play out of it and gets it right there. Easy value out of that. Looking for more. Oh, that's not happening. This tower is hitting him for like 70 damage per hit.
He has the Satyr Blast, so even though it's a ridiculous amount of mana, that's a nice little finishing move if they can catch Legion Commander off guard. But
don't
this leaves the
to.
No solo,
tell. Oh, nice juking.
Oh, he's seen.
He's gonna live.
Wonder where he went. Radiant's Solo has absolutely no attack. Regen right now, and Radiant's the runes were taken. Are fortified. I don't think he got anything in his bottle for that last rune. He's gonna get a tango there for now. And not very often you see not only a Tidehunter in like a side lane with support as support, but as a roamer as well. Chavos try to kill Misery. Nice telekinesis. He's gonna try to right click, but not gonna be enough. Chavos is gonna tank the tower. Nicely done. So Navi coming out with an advantage now in this top lane.
Radiant's top tower is under attack. And also gets. He's level 6, so now ganking him for for Team Secret is almost 100% dependent on Storm jumping or Doom getting level 6. It's very easy playing Lycan in this game for the next 5 or 10 minutes, so expecting Kvost to get really good farm doesn't really need to be afraid of anything at this point.
S4 level 6. Legion Commander about to hit level 6, he's gonna get stunned. No-Tail has the Gush, has the Anchor Smash. Misery a little bit too late. That probably wouldn't have been enough. The Satyr Blast only deals like 125 damage, so you have to be really low to get that. But still trying to get to this bottom rune, the 6-minute mark, but he'll be scared away, and Solo will get this one. If it's a bounty, he... No, I don't think so, actually. If it was a bounty, he wouldn't have gotten level 6 still.
Dyer's I think he would.
Tower
is isn't it,
oh, that's really close. 50
it's
plus
100.
2...
Yeah.
It's 50 plus 2 per minute. Or 5 per minute on XP and 2 on gold. It's been 6 minutes, so we would have got 80. That would have been level 6, actually.
There you
go. He could have made the play anyway. So.
Kuroki left to his own devices in bottom lane. Level 6 right now. Oh, look at this. That is so weird. He has the crit icon, but nothing else. I didn't even know that he could do that. So the headpiece gives you one icon. And the sword gives you the rest, I think. That's really,
really
weird. That is so strange.
That's hilarious.
I didn't think they broke
it up like
that.
He has the custom crit.
Yeah.
That's funny.
That is quite odd. But like I said, he's left to his own devices here, so he's gonna get all the farm that he wants. PA in the meantime, where is she? Well, in a fountain right now. We'll see where she ends up going. Misery might be getting ganked here. This is a tri lane, technically speaking. Make it a quad lane, a fourth is coming. If they can get a telekinesis,
totally
this will be pretty easy. He's gonna heal up quite a bit from Scorched Earth, but look at the damage, the physical DPS. Goblax heal. With
he
the wolves.
Poor armor with Tranquils and no stout. You just get completely destroyed by Navi's heroes with Howl. They're not going to be able to get the tower if Puppy keeps getting these strong Illuminates off. Seeing Funnic very
Radiant's
aggressive dive to get him away.
Under attack.
Yep,
might secure. Looks like it will. No glyph. Get the first tower. So it's a start, and Kvost is getting really good farm still. He should be overtaking Kuro by quite a bit. He's now about 1,000 ahead of the Jugger, 500 ahead of Storm. And it needs to continue this way. This is Navi's path to winning this game, is getting the Lycan so big that he has to be jumped by Storm and Doom mid lane solo. Oh, that was really cutting it close from S4. If he gets dual there, he's dead.
Yeah, absolutely. Kuroki did end up going Panda Midas, so taking advantage of this complete free farm in bottom lane and now jungle. So I think that's... What do you think about that choice? I think, I mean, generally speaking, you're like 50-50, I feel like, but I think this is one case you're probably okay with it, I would assume.
Yeah, Midas and Jug is, he scales really well with the levels, right? The Omni Slash is extremely powerful on levels 2 and 3, so That part of it is really nice. However, you also generally want to play Juggernaut in kind of a mid-game situation with some core items to do a lot of damage, but I think Secret's game plan in this one isn't to win the game early, because I think they realize that it's very unlikely that they can just push an end against this Na'Vi lineup. They have some decent defensive potential between Overwhelming Odds, Fate Bolt, Weave is a very good defensive tool as well. So they're probably just going to play a farm and whatever split push they can gain again, just like in games 1 and 2.
Solo looking for the duel, but he's the one getting kited completely. Anchor smash. Here's the jump
duel
in
now
from
with Grave
S4.
Available.
That's true. He could. He's actually going to jump in completely.
Oh, wow.
He's trying to bait it. He's trying to bait it as much as possible, and S4 just gets the hell out of there before anything else happens.
Just using the regen to its max effect.
Oh, that's
keep
true.
Jumping.
Yeah, he did have a regen. That is the best regen carrying hero by far. Even DD, I guess you could argue as well.
DD is... I want to say DD is better on heroes that have a natural crit, like PA or... PA is the extreme case, probably.
Something they didn't mention that is something it's kind of overlooked from time to time, because when you look at Midas, it's like, okay, I get gold and extra experience and whatnot. The attack speed is actually super helpful for the Juggernaut, because the more attack speed you get, the better your ult is, because you have those little in-between auto attacks, if you will, which
yep.
could crit. So that's going to be super nice, especially when you don't go treads on the Juggernaut. So he goes Phase Boots, which is more of a kill me now build, so that's actually a little bit strange. Actually, what do you think about that? Treads versus Phase Boots on Jug.
I like Phase a lot for the synergy with Blade Fury, but has he? He's going full stats. He's got stats 5 times and 1 in each skill. Which is the first time
that.
I think I ever see this.
Interesting.
So if he maxed Blade Fury, I could... The synergy with Phase Boost is obvious. You Blade Fury and then you Phase and then you can stay on top of targets, which is great, but... I'm not quite sure what to think of this build, because all of Juggernaut's skills are actually really good. And taking this many points in stats is something I haven't seen before, so... I can't really relate to it in any way. The best comparison I can make is that it's like an anti-mage, right? The burning build on AM. But Juggernaut just doesn't really scale in the same way.
Jumped on by S4, stunned on top of that puppy, has an Illuminate coming into effect, finally gets it off. But I can't quite blink at it. It's a safety. So he will die. Yeah, Well, if you think about it, if he's thinking Legion Commander, well, it could be that, or it could be Legion Commander might be getting a Blink Dagger. Well, will be getting one. Wants to survive through that or something to that effect, I'm not sure. But if you're gonna do that, and I'm not saying this is wrong by any means, obviously he's a way better player than me, but like, why not go treads then instead of phase boots? Because you're not really getting the full effect of the phase boots, I feel like.
I think he farms faster with phase. Everything in Kuroki's inventory and his skill build just screams farm, right? It's like, okay, if he wanted the most effective farming, I think he could get more out of Blade Dance level 4 than out of stats, but that's the only thing, right? So, it seems like the gameplay call from the team is just get rich. We don't worry about them pushing us because we have a Keeper of the Light on defense and we have a Tide Ravage, so we're very difficult to push into. You guys just farm as much as you can, so okay, Coors Light, fair enough, boss. Let me get a Midas and farm as much as I can with stats build, and then Doom gets a Midas too, so... I guess that's the reasoning, but it's a very, very strange build.
Yeah, I didn't even notice Doom's Midas, that's true.
He just
for the
picked
late
it up
game, that's
well,
for sure.
So.
And this is a quadruple stack at the Ancients, I believe.
So that's gonna yes, be looks like it.
Probably for Tidehunter. Well, actually,
but this
maybe
is harder
it's not
than
for
it used
Tidehunter,
to be.
Actually. Yeah, you gotta kill the Ancient Golem now, because look at the health on all these guys.
So the
15%.
Problem with this is for Tide, for example, he can't kill the single target he wants very fast.
Dire's
he kills all of them at once.
Right.
So it basically takes Tide like 15% longer to destroy this Ancient stack. A hero like Juggernaut can just target the Golem first and then get all the others after. But I don't know. I'm really curious to see what Kuro's next item is.
Do you think this stack is for him? I mean, who else can take it, I guess? Like, Juggernaut doesn't have any cleave, but... I mean, the only reason I ask is because... Yeah, he could be. The only reason I ask is Tidehunter, like we talked about so many times, he's not playing the normal role.
Oh my god.
What?
Master Madness. I don't know, this is...
Even more attack speed. Great.
That's some fucked up shit. No, I don't know.
That's some fucked up shit, I'll tell you what. Vonic, in the meantime, top lane's gonna get ganked from Misery. And S4, the Doom is there. S4 jumps in as well. He's gonna get healed a bit from Solo. S4 jumping around. Vonic will... Oh, nice duel is gonna prevent any more damage to Vonic. who might live to see another day. In fact, he might jump in. He's gonna live. They're gonna try to find Misery. He does not have enough mana for his teleport. And the question is, do they know that?
Did he just... No, okay. FNG found him.
The Scorched Earth from FNG.
Oh my god, you almost shoot them.
Well, they're gonna kill him meanwhile. In the same lane, Kuroki's here with the Mask of Madness. And the Omni Slash with Nice Grave, though. Gonna basically nullify the entire ult. He's gonna steal it on top of this. See if he can find anybody as his target of choice. S4's gonna blink, or use his ult, I should say, and then TP out. And the chase is now on Kuroki. He's gonna get slowed. I don't know, he's gonna Blade Fury out of his effect.
Oh, this is good. He's good.
He is good to go. The Omni Slash would have canceled and killed him in all likelihood, but Rubick has absolutely no mobility right now. But that's still a really good ult to take, obviously. It's level 2, actually, I didn't realize.
This is one. This is probably the best skill in the game he can get right now, apart from Ravage. He could kill No-Tail now. Almost. He's gonna need a little bit of health. Maybe not.
Oh no! He's gonna get stunned from S4 and the turnaround is there! It was close, I don't blame him. I don't blame him one bit.
No, he was dead if he didn't try it, so might as well, right?
True.
He was already spotted and had no escape, like you said. But needed just a little bit of a poke from someone else on the team to get that kill. And that's just, that's Kraken Shell and 4 armor there on Tide keeping him alive, basically.
5-3 advantage for Secret at the moment. Kuroki gonna continue with the... Yeah, he's gonna try to take out these Ancients. With the Healing Ward's gonna help, but of course no Cleave to work with. Good god. The Ancients are destroying him. No-Tail's gonna come in, try to help out with that Anchor Smash. Lower the damage a bit, and that should be enough now. So it ended up is being Kuroki taking out the majority of the stack. Instead of the Tide. Tide's very underfarmed at the moment. What's coming in? This is a Blink Dagger. That's for No-Tail. Okay, forget it. He's got his core item. He's
Radiant's
good to go.
Middle tower is under attack.
And it should be noted as well that if it eventually ends up going for a refresher, that was somewhat nerfed as well.
Dire's top tower
is there a bug with Dire's when the Ancient Granite Golem dies that other creeps get healed somehow? Because it looked like out of principle he killed that one last. He killed all the other creeps and then the Ancient Granite Golem, one last swing.
There was a bug with Armlet where you get healed, but I don't think for normal.
I heard
usage.
Something about the Ancient Granite Golem. I think I read that there was some weird bug where when that died, creeps got healed back or something because the calculation was wrong. I don't know if that's why he did it, but looked kind of funny. He took that creep out last.
Based on principle and principle alone.
Is this a tower trade? Fortified. Navi will be getting bot tier 1. Top tier 1 goes to S4.
They might have seen solo.
Looks like they have.
Jumps in. S4 looking for the kill. He's going to get some backup in the form of the Doom, but Gallblack is here to prevent any more aggression coming from Secret. Phonic is super underfarmed at the moment. He'd go for
Dire's
middle. He's going to get gushed. The Blink is available if they really want to go for this. Kuroki's getting sent back to base. Okay, never mind. Back 10 feet south. And the Ravage is placed. It's going to be for the Lycan Clubhouse. He put on a clip from Blinding Light. He gets doomed on top of that. This poor wolf can do nothing but die. Even the Blade Fury being used for full effect is for very little effect, in fact. He will eventually die. This is the longest death of all time on Lycan on a cliff. Sad to see, but it happens from time to time.
What a sick blind from Puffy. Wow. That was crazy. And I think he actually needed to get him up there. If he would have been in the river, you saw, he would probably just run away.
That's a level 1 Doom. That's why it took so freaking long. Good god. Yeah. Did like no damage. Well, this tower's in quite a bit of peril. Funny.
Kuro is still going for bomb round. He went Mask of Madness and then Maelstrom. Just full focus on the farm.
Solo wants to jump in. Probably doesn't want to go for the Juggernaut. Funny is like, I'm jumping in, but I have no items actually. I forgot about that. Here's the slow on Puppy.
He's trying it.
There's the duel. Who's going to get the kill? It's going to be close. Actually, nice grade. This is gonna, no, he doesn't even get the duel. And in fact, he's gonna end up trading his life one way or another. Funic still trying to run away in the river, but is too dead for only the Keeper of the Light is the trade. LC has the Blink available to get out if need be. They're trying to bait this in for Hovos with that newly picked up Necronomicon book. It's Misery. No armor.
Misery just has no armor.
Misery is miserable with no armor.
Dies.
I'm gonna try to use this level 2 Necro to push a little bit. This tier 1 tower still available to take.
It's still really interesting to see how fast Kuro is farming. He's out farming a Lycan as Juggernaut. And I know he went for a Midas, but even then, Lycan farms extremely fast, given the safe lane which he was.
Another Blinding Light. Wow, these Blinding Lights have been insane. They can finish him off. A Grave at the last second. It's going to save his life, and he's going to be really fast. S4 getting dueled. Damage should go away the Solo's way, and it does. They're going to continue the aggression. We have Storm Spirit buying back, and Rubick actually stole his ultimate. He gets put on the cliff there. Puppy and company. They're going to surround Funnic, who is just going to drop dead. Poor Funnic just has, like, not enough farm to do anything. And we have the ridiculous battle of Storm Spirit ults, and the Storm Spirit wins in the end. So the buyback was not in vain at all. There's the drums, that's something for survivability. But this is probably a tier 2 tower down in the favor of Secret. And the problem with PA is, at this stage of the game, you want to have a little bit more than this. He has Tranquils, Drums. What's up with the Tranquils, by the way?
I think he needed it to sustain in the lane he was given. This is just, you know, putting PA off lane in a dual lane like this in a lane you can't win is very, very difficult for her to deal with. I think Funnic has been playing okay. It's a hard situation, and the trade-off for Lycan has been okay as well. Like, it's not that Kvost has been wasting his time. He has a Necro 3 Vlads and Medallion at 20, which is certainly very good farm. But he needs to get some job done now, so they can get PA back in the game.
Look at this build on Kuroki, this is amazing, I love it. Mjolnir on top of everything else. So he's basically attacking at... Is he trying to get to that, like, 600 new attack speed? Is that what's going on here? Let's just get, like, 5 more Mjolnir, and then you'll be good to go, I think.
I don't know. He's certainly keeping up the pace.
Solo.
Does he have 522 move speed when he uses phase and mask? I think he does. He wants max attack and move speed this game.
Did he just get brought back to his current location? Is that what just happened? The recall? Awesome.
I don't know.
This is going to be a group effort to try to take out Roshan. If Secret doesn't want to contest, they'll take the tier 2. Not sure if they really care. In fact, there's no way they contest this. That's the one thing that Na'Vi has going for them. They have a ridiculously good Roshan.
And they have no idea what's happening either. Because you see how they're playing in the top lane. They were really worried that a fight was going to break out from Na'Vi. But they got Roshan for free instead. Didn't look like Secret were... Either they weren't aware of that happening, or they couldn't. You know, they couldn't take the risk anyway. Like you said, you don't Radiant's really want to fight into the line of the rush. Although Ravage and Storm and Juggernaut, I think they might have actually had a shot at it. Out of position at the point in time. But also the losing tier 1 mid to boost. This is really good for Na'Vi getting these two objectives for free.
S4 is invisible, but the sentry is just in range if they have it. Oh. He's going to orchid it at the last second though, and S4 is going to use it defensively. Top tower, and it's probably going to break things up completely. By the way, usually we don't have to mention this, but... I guess it's worth it. Mechanisms picked up by somebody, Cinderin.
Puppy has it. Kotl got it.
Kotl, very good.
He's probably
very good
getting
pickup.
An axe next, I think. This
How
is
do
the
you
usual
feel about
build.
Axe on Keeper of the Light, Cinderin?
It's very good.
I have
good.
No idea.
I love it. So, most of Keeper of the Lights I see these days, I think, do get the mech into axe build, unless there's a force staff somewhere in between. We'll see what route Puppy takes, but the axe upgrade is certainly going to be good for when, especially when they're sieging the base. Being able to sustain through all the overwhelming odds and all the fate bolts by just healing with the wave should be really nice, but... See
he
when that time comes.
He has 518 move speed, so he needs drums or a Yasha to get that 522. It's definitely not going to be the drums. But...
Second Mjolnir.
Is it actually?
Not for move speed, just attack speed.
Okay. That would be so hilarious if he was double Mjolnir. Here we have the initiation on a Goblin, like a good choice for the Orchid. He can't get the Grave off. He needs a little bit more mana to secure the kill, and he does so.
Why didn't Solo press the attack on him?
Press the attack, well, he's gonna use it on S4. Nice! Ravage from No Tail, who gets the dual kill. It's actually gonna end up being Secret at the end of the day. The Aegis is popped. Kuroki and company, do they want to go any further? FNG in the trees. There we have Funnic getting doomed. Omni Slash on top of everything else, dealing absolutely ridiculous damage. Funnic drops the doom in the end, and Kvost will be next on the list. FNG, the last remaining member of Na'Vi. And he's not even a member because he's a stand-in. But they're going to continue. Look at... Well, he has to stand still now. And the crit! The crit!
Not going to lie, this build from Kuro fucking hurts.
It's pretty awesome.
I mean, when you play it like this, I think his skill build is really good. I still don't understand why he didn't get 4 points in Blade Dance though, but the rest of his build seems to be working out very nicely. Top tower is under
attack. Well, I still have Grave
totally
available.
Unheard of, by the way, in Jordan.
Well, this is Captain's Trap, so anything's possible, Cinderin.
Look at him healing.
Look at this. Max speed. Okay. Yeah, it's gonna hurt him quite a bit, but they did do damage to the tier 3. Solo has only 28 damage from duels, and I believe that means 2, right? Oh, that's 2 level 2s.
Yes, 2 level 2 duels.
That means he
duels.
Didn't get any level 1 duels. That's surprising. Yeah.
It's not or it's a level 1 and level 3, but I can't have a case in this one. So. But this is really, you know, I'm generally not a big fan of heroes getting blade mail after 30 minutes, but I think it might even be the best item for Legion Commander in this game. Just having blade mail on and dueling Kuro, he's gonna kill himself so fast.
Yeah, has 4 jumps and I'm funny. Doesn't have a whole lot of mana to work with now, though. He's gonna be forced back. This. Okay, it gets disjointed. The range on Stifling Dagger is just dumb. S4 still doesn't have much mana. He does have a little bit of backup. He has Orchid.
Oh, they're gonna take Misery instead, I think. Okay.
We'll see. S4 can jump a little bit. TP support could come. Here comes the jump in from Misery. He's gonna doom FNG. Unfortunately, he can't steal it since he is silenced at the end of the day. And they're gonna apply all the pressure now to Misery with the very little armor that he has. One more Stifling Dagger will do it. He just drops it on his own accord. So 2 dead for Secret.
Can they get a collateral though? Navi really needs something else. Something more, rather.
Solo looking for Puppy. Oh yeah, that must feel real good killing that horse. Killing that old man on that horse, I tell you what. Kuroki.
Hey guys, I want a duel against an old man on a horse.
He's very happy about that. A big ravage from No-Tail on 4. Kuroki has Omni Slash to work with as well. A nice Grave on both. Gonna keep him alive at least for now. The Omni Slash doesn't really have any good bounces. Tidehunter drops to the deck and Kuroki is now in a 1v3 situation, trying to right click to victory, getting slowed completely. And Solo is here. A 4v1, a team wipe for Na'Vi. Fortification popped on top of this. They should be able to get this tier 2. That was pretty ballsy. The Omni Slash did not have good bounces, I'll give him that. He's basically on the.
Also,
the
perfect
target.
Play from Goblack. Grave was perfect, his Self Ghost Scepter was perfect. And that's what happens if you build Juggernaut like this, right? Well, you can't really fault the build. They went in 2 on 4, right? So.
They pulled the Havos, man.
But, yeah, they tried the outnumber battle. It was pretty close, but. Really huge for Na'Vi. That's the whole game back. They were 10,000 gold behind and about the same on experience. We're back to reach almost 0 XP and the gold close to 4k. This last 2 minutes, they've just pulled the whole game back. Exciting once again.
And Fonic is finally starting to get some farm. He has 1,100 gold in the bank. I think he had something in there. Is it Mithril? No, it's a Yasha. So a full Yasha. I don't know why I would say full Yasha, but he has completed it. We have another pause. Hopefully this is nothing serious. In fact, once it pauses, we should stop talking about Dota and go on to other things.
Oh yeah, that's true. Where were we?
I don't know. We talked about so much today. I feel like I know you so much better. Not really.
Okay.
But I still love you so much.
It's kind of crazy. We've managed to play 2 games in 4 hours. Or that's 2.5. To be fair. Or maybe more than a half, depending on how long this game goes, but...
Man, feels
that
like
pause
the summit,
must have been
man.
Really long, because we didn't have much downtime apart from that pause. It's only one time, right? There was no other pauses. Or...
Well, at the beginning of the game, there was a couple pauses, but nothing major.
Yeah, a few minutes here and there, I guess.
So tell me about your life. I don't know why I found that so funny. Just delirious at this point. BKB, I ruined it. I ruined it. BKB picked up by a Storm Spirit.
My life is like a BKB. You could have, you know, tried to.
You never know to get what you're gonna get, except for the 10-second immunity. Yes, medical. So when's the next A to Z? Let's just schedule everything while we have a pause. Yeah, for those wondering, we have an A to Z scheduled for Monday. Yep. Unfortunately, it's on the old patch, so that's kind of sucks, but...
Fortunately, however, it's a little bit of a special treat that we don't want to spoil for you.
It's a real special, is it?
Yes.
I don't remember anything about it being special.
Yeah, I'm not surprised. You're getting old and...
So old and decrepit, yes. Speaking of old and decrepit, Ghost Scepter now on Puppy. So did not go for the patented...
Why are you talking about the game again?
Aghanim Scepter? I don't know. I wish
Googles.
I could tell my... Are you? How have you not finished that by now? In America, you finished that within an hour.
I can't eat while I'm casting.
No,
what the hell?
You've been eating constantly.
I'm taking one little bugle at a time.
No, as a fat man, I can't wait for your metabolism to just finally catch up with you one of these days. You're going to be obese like me one day. Anyway, back to the game. Gallblack for Na'Vi has a Ghost Scepter himself. It's going to be quite good against Juggernaut. Of course, remember, it does not cancel the Omni Slash. That is, I guess that's an old change now, but in case you didn't realize, it'll just continue to bounce but deal no damage. And Misery going for a Shiva's. Might have it. No, the recipe's the last thing needed. Another 300-400 gold. And instead of a Blade Mail, which I would have agreed on big time like you talked about on Legion Commander, he's actually going for either an Assault or a Mjolnir himself.
AC is very good too. They have so much physical damage on their team. It's really, it gives a lot of value. The question is if they feel like what they need to do is counter the Juggernaut mainly or the entire enemy team. Like, what are they most afraid of? Kuro?
Whoa, big jump and big
particular?
Jump back out. And now the chase is on. Necronomicon level 3, Bob Puppy in a lot of trouble, gonna get telekinesis and absolutely destroyed. Eventually he'll go down. It's gonna happen some one of these times. There you go, that's a good boy.
Wow, he goes instantly blown up there after the Ghost Scepter postponed his death for 4 seconds and he used mech and it took them a little longer. Instant kill.
But the cool thing about that is, if he hadn't had that, they could have chased extra heroes, but by the time he died,
probably,
everybody was completely out of there, so something to actually take note of, for sure. Unlike when Syndra played and died insta-give every time, space was created by Puppy, isn't that right, Syndra? I'm sorry.
Radiance, you know, we used to be friends, and now I
eat your bugles, okay? I'm just jealous of your bugles.
I barely see you as an acquaintance at this point. That's how far down you've dropped on my tier list.
An acquaintance? That sounds super sexual. I don't know why I think that. Anyway, top lane,
I have no
idea
either.
Haste on solo. He has the blink duel available to him, but Kuroki can feel tinglings in those testicles of his. And he does have 4 levels in Blade Dance now, so you'll be happy to see that. Level 19 with 1 level of Blade Fury.
I guess he couldn't skill stats anymore.
I mean, the Blade Fury picked up just for magic immunity. I mean, the damage is negligible, especially at this point of the game. Healing Ward. I don't know, I'm not going to question his build at all. It's just super weird, right?
What the fuck?
More attack speed, Eagle Song.
Yeah, well.
You know what would make this weirder? If he just goes Ethereal instead of Butterfly. Let's just do that, Kuroki. Jump in bottom lane. It's a Doom on. Wait, what the hell did he just do? What the hell did he just do? Was it a creep? Either way, Solo's going to pop his BKB. He's going to try to find Misery, who does have a TP available to him. He's going to blink. TP.
He actually gets out.
And
oh,
he's
dear.
Out. Was that a Doom creep, or is that
I
just
I don't know,
me?
I didn't see it. I didn't even hear it.
I heard it.
Oh, it must have been. What else can you do him? Not the tower. That would be pretty sick, though.
Disable the attack of the tower.
Well, just the pure damage, that. If that went through. That would be nice.
Well, bottom lane. Funnik and company. Okay, this is going to be a full Manta on Funnik. I keep saying full, as if... Whatever. I didn't care anymore. It's a full Manta. Full Havost. Has 1600 gold on top of all this. Mechanism is being picked up by the opposing team now. It's going to be Gallblack. So this is Mechanism Gaming, guys. Good to see. S4 still has... it's a 10-second BKB, so he's had this for a decent amount of time. And there's the Butterfly.
Yeah, this build of Kuroki's is going to ultimately, I think, get overpowered by Na'Vi's heroes. So he has insane amounts of attack speed and will obviously hit really hard for now. But the moment Na'Vi's heroes start getting some more armor, and especially... What was I thinking? Especially the evasion of PA is going to cause him a lot of problems now that he doesn't have MKB, and PA hasn't been a problem so far, but she's going to become one with her next item after the Manta. And the moment his Omni Slash is over, any sort of control on him, and he's dead. And he can't use Blade Fury, because it's useless, right? Especially late game, and especially when it's level 1. So...
Don't knock it, man. Don't knock it.
They'll probably just, if they get, let's say, I mean, Goblek's getting really rich. I don't think a Hex is out of the question for him to reach in this game, having both Force Mech and Ghost Scepter now. or maybe the Rubik after his blink, or they just get a Yules, for example, and just freeze him in time a little bit and get some space. And they could probably take him.
Let's see how fast he attacks. Point, he attacks over 3 times per second with Mask of Madness activated.
Top tower.
Ooh, that's dirty. That is really dirty. Of course.
This reminds me of my favorite pub sniper build, with just all out attack speed, reaching
for
like
the even
just machine
just a
gun
pub build anymore. People do that.
No, I'm gonna be like 4 Mjolnirs.
He doesn't have 4 Mjolnirs.
No,
he's
that's
gonna
the
deal
sniper
a lot of damage
to
this tower. No fortify up. They could maybe go for Rakram. Rakabut jumps in, gets doomed, BKBs, runs away. At least he got his ultimate off. They're gonna take the Ranger Axe, if not more. What was stolen? It was Omni Slash again. Here we go. Omni Slashing, but there's a lot of creeps to tank up that damage, so there's really no effect whatsoever. Lycan's finally back. Still kinda doomed. Now finally runs out. Solo gets a duel onto S4. Looks like it's gonna be an easy kill coming the way of Na'Vi. So not quite a full Rax. But the range and well the melee's gonna heal up a little bit over time. I feel like if they're gonna lose that many, might as well just go
for
the kill.
Oh, here we go,
Hiroki.
Bottom.
Von Nick, trying to run away. He did it!
Damn it.
Top plays of the week!
He dodged a couple of attacks. Oh, here we go. Still running.
We have an incoming
Uh-oh.
Misery with Shivas. Oh, the haste is there! So close, but yet so far. So the funny thing is, I could have sworn Kuroki was just Omni Slashing, but that's just his regular attack.
How did Secret get away with getting those Rex for free? So I think the PA wanted to port top and help. I think she was drained out of her mana by Keeper of the Light before she got a TP scroll or something. Because she stayed there and fought Coddle the whole time instead of porting up and helping. And she was out of mana, so that must have been the reason. So that's really unfortunate for Na'Vi there. They lose only the ranged barracks though, so melee still standing strong and obviously the more important of the barracks. And if they get another dual kill now, I think you could almost say it might have been worth it. Because I want to say, come late game, I still think they have a pretty good shot. Misery will be dying here.
Oh my god! Oh, he got it. That was as close as it gets.
Storm has not been getting extremely good farm. He's 33 minutes in with 140, which is pretty low. The Storm Spirit.
That's Storm.
And it's because Juggernaut's taken everything. So Juggernaut is almost 10 CS per minute, but that does drain the map when you're also sharing farm with the Doom, and even the Tide of No-Tail has 100, because he needs to get the Refresher. And if they reach that point, it's going to be like 2 stages, I think. Before No-Tail reaches Refresher in the next 15 minutes, I think Na'Vi are going to reach a point when they're stronger, and then when the Refresher comes, I think Secret are cruising towards the ultra-late game and probably winning that. But I don't know. What's Kuro building next? What ideas?
MKB, I think it has to be, right?
MKB is good, Kiras is good, MKB is particularly good, obviously, against the PA. I don't know.
Radiant's middle tower.
Okay, Na'Vi
is still on FNG, by the way.
They're just going down mid. Oh, that's true.
It's up for... Well,
yes,
yeah,
for more than a minute.
Illuminate's going to try
like
to defend this
a
bit.
Radiant structures
trying to slow down
fortified.
This push as much as possible with a fortification, but they do have a fortified orb with Na'Vi does, but I don't know if they can stop this Rax from... Okay, they can. All it takes is 2 TPs. They're out. They're out and about. FNG gets cancelled. He uses his Omni Slash. Trying to get as much out of it as possible. It really doesn't do that much damage on that poor little Rubik who's going to get chased down. Looks like S4 and company are running away at top lane as well. FNG. He's going to get Grave Event. Oh no, the jump in and Doom onto Goblack. They might be able to get 2 kills out of this. Well, PA ends up killing Juggernaut in the top. FNG's still somehow running away. S4's like, fuck this, just kill him! Jumps in, destroys his face. Solo? Looking for a duel, not going to find it. Man, this spell, I swear to God, is so annoying. Freaking mana leak, man. Yeah. It lasts for so long.
It's a really good spell. I like that it got buffed, because I feel like this spell used to be trash tier at one point. It's been buffed a couple of times since then.
It's too good. It's too
now
good.
It's a 3-second stun, which is insane when it runs out. So, cool ability. That was a really chaotic fight. I honestly can't tell you who came out on top in that. I guess Na'Vi slightly, because Kuro died, but...
Yeah.
They still... They, lose
oh, they didn't lose
they
a
used
Rax
a lot
or
of
anything.
Stuff. Yeah, they didn't lose Rax. They also didn't lose either Aegis or Chi. So yeah, Na'Vi probably winning that by a little bit. From running
the
around.
Aegis isn't going to be there much longer. Less than a minute away. And, well, the cheese will always be delicious for Phonic to use if it really wants to. Wait, who has the Aegis? I thought you said it wasn't used. Okay, it's on Legion Commander.
Yep.
And she is going for MKB, I suppose, against the Butterfly choice. Speaking of Juggernaut, what does he have? 3,400 gold, Midas needs to be used immediately. He's probably crying about it right now. Misery is working on a BKB, unless it's going to be a Halberd, which wouldn't be that bad of a choice, honestly. And what else do we have? Khovost had a lot of gold. What did he pick up? MKB. So it's going to be MKBs all around. Great for both sides. Yeah. And it's going to be
mainly
a smoke.
Mainly Cameron Coral, of course.
No smoke?
I think Weave might be the really big player this game, but he's not. Oh boy, Dazzle isn't there, and he doesn't have a TP. If this fight breaks out, it's effectively 5-on-4, but Na'Vi scouted out with a Wolf. Good play from Frost, keeping him safe.
0.3 attacks per second with Mask of Madness. He doesn't deal that much damage, right? It's mostly attack speed, but it ends up evening out overall.
That's the problem, right? Because even if he gets a damage item now, the way this build is tailored, sure, you hit a truckload of times, but the enemy team has so much... When you get to this stage in the game, the enemy team has like a Kirass and a Vlads. The whole team has a lot of armor. And no matter what a Juggernaut builds, he will need a lot of hits to kill someone off and can always be countered with Ghost Scepter unless he has Diffusal, but then he needs to use an item slot on that, or someone else in the team does. And you, considering how much farm they've put on Koro, I think this could end up being a really poor investment in comparison to getting S4 really farmed in this game, or, you know, Kuro aiming for a classic mid-game build and them trying to win the game there. Instead, they're playing an ultra-late game Juggernaut with no defensive capabilities, and that can backfire. Oh, good Doom.
And they're
going to
jump in off the boss. He can't get an ultimate. That's going to be an easy kill for Secret. Solo jumps in. Can he get S4 before the duel is over? They're both going to die. I can't even tell who won the freaking duel. Grok in the meantime, chasing Funic, pops his Manta, gets Gust right afterwards. Goblack is there. He has Grid if he really needs it. Ravage is going to hit one beautiful force attack from Goblack, avoiding that completely. Cheese is popped from Funic. He's going to blink onto Goblack. His mana is going to continue to be drained by this ridiculously OP spell. Gets Gust. He'll be okay. And here we have buyback TP. Somebody just gets wrecked onto that tower. No-Tail, four staff TP, gets Telekinesis right off the bat. Kuroki's gonna TP out safely. No-Tail has Ghost Scepter, but he is completely surrounded. Solo does not have duel for another 10 seconds. And a crit from Funic finishes him off. Meanwhile, top lane. Oh my goodness, no Fortify. This is gonna be melee Rax. Okay, he TP's out. I'm surprised he didn't spin TP. How did he... Do they have any instant... They have Telekinesis. I guess he can tell who's TPing, right? So...
Yeah, I don't know. I guess the way he's playing Juggernaut, he forgot that skill exists.
Yeah, that too. He goes Manta, by the way.
Yeah.
What does that take off?
Well, he can. I think it's mainly just for the split pushing and the confusion in team fights. There's nothing it really counters that well, I want to say, on Na'Vi's side. Stifling Dagger. Poison Touch, I think, persists through it. It's one of the special abilities that I think you can't take off. Medallion, maybe? Does that persist through as well? And it's so rare you see this, anyway, so...
I'll take that as tribute.
Is he gonna skill Blade Fury? Okay, this is moment of truth. Does Kuro refuse?
At this point, you don't skill it, honestly. Come on, you gotta go all out.
It only gets better by skilling it. And he's still not doing it.
Typically, that's how skills work.
Nah, some of them get like higher mana cost, for example.
Oh, sure.
Like, they get worse in some way, but no. Blade Fury gets more damage and lower cooldown, and he's still not skilling it.
He's a stubborn man, that Kuroki. He's Persian after all. Funic pops his Mantis, gonna take Omni Law. Beautifully done, man. That was sick. Great Blink Strike. I hear a Doom. It's applied to Solo. He's gonna try to run away. Goblock is here. He could Grave, but it's only gonna prevent, or it's gonna delay the inevitable. He's gonna die one way or another. There he goes. Doom now has an Aghanim Scepter. Funic picked up the MKB officially. Did he still not skill it? He has. He's finally come to grips with things. Somebody PM'd him like, hey, you should skill Blade Fury.
Hey, it only gets better. Maybe you have a slight chance of using it for something.
But, I mean, at this point, it's not like it matters. The damage doesn't matter at all. It's really about the magic immunity. And the push will continue. Dire's bottom in all likelihood. Is under attack. We're gonna have some TP support.
They're porting him down.
Fonic got big ravage on two. Fonic is extremely low. Nice grave from FNG. Chabot pops the BKB. He's gonna try to right click S4, who's continuing to kill that poor little Dazzler, the poor little Rubik. 2-0 right now for Seekers, but they're starting to back up. And Misery taking a ton of damage to this freaking Lycan, man. He's just chasing him down to all targets content. Poison touch applied to him. Kavost, after all that, he just dies, so it's a 4-0. Definite advantage going Seeker's way. Goblock, the last remaining survivor, he had the grave up, but was just not in range. And in all likelihood, will be a full team wipe.
Man, I was sure. I didn't see how the fight was open, but Kuro was not in it. He got ported by the Caudle across the map, and right before he got ported in, Lycan hit him with one wolf. So that whole fight was 5-on-4 until the last 5 seconds with Kuro came in. So they won the fight 5-on-4. I don't know. They jumped and killed the
He didn't even use Omni Slash.
They jumped and killed the LC, right? They jumped and killed the LC. Grave didn't come off. And yeah, without duel, and I guess also just Anchor Smash, just left, right, and center, just removes so much of their damage. Like, even though their lineup has a lot of physical, they all need to come in close, and Notel can play a huge role.
There's no way Solo was expecting that to still be up after that huge mayhem fight. FNG, this looks like the last stand for Na'Vi. It's gonna end up being 3-0 to Secret. And Secret will find Virtus Pro in the grand finals tomorrow in that best of 5 series.
And that's a rematch of what was basically the battle of the first place of the round robin. So, following the trends, BP won 2-0 last time. Let's see if they can do it again tomorrow. That would be a really big story for VP to win a tournament, especially against Secret, but Secret looked pretty much on fire today. I think Misery played well in all the games as well. Of course, he was the question